In this video, we are going to look at how to access library databases using a Chrome Incognito browser window or a Firefox Private browser window. So the first stage of accessing our databases is going to our databases page. You'll see that at the top of the page, we have a note in red that says, please use a Chrome Incognito browser when accessing our databases. This is the preference, but for some of our databases, you can also use Firefox's private browser window as well. So first, let's take a look at using Chrome Incognito. I'm just going to go into this first area and look at the very first database we come to. Now, you'll see I could click this link and it would open the browser in this same window. But if instead I want to open this in Chrome Incognito, what I'll do is I will right-click and I will get a menu that pops up. And using this menu, I can select the third option down, which is Open Link in Incognito Window. Selecting that pops up this new browser window, which you'll see has black framing at the top. This is an incognito window. It also indicates this up here in the upper right-hand corner where it says incognito. I can now sign in using my normal sign-in information, which is the part of your email address before the at symbol, your FIT email address, and the password that you would use to get into Blackboard, MyFIT, or other FIT services. Now I can use the database as I normally would. Now let's look at the same database in Firefox. If I come down to the link again, I will again right-click on it, and you'll see that in the same location, there's Open Link in New Private Window. This is the equivalent of what they call incognito in a Chrome browser. I would click this link, and it will open a new window where I can log into the database using my normal login information. So that's how you can log in using an incognito browser or private browser, depending on which type of browser you're using, Chrome or Firefox.
If you have questions on this or anything else, please ask the library.